Well, imagine a guy who never wanted to be a photographer, but the circumstances that led more and more to it. And where did I learn it? I was as a boy in the farm of my grandfather. It was during the war, there were cows and chickens and things, and they had flies there. So they flew around in the big farm, and I started catching them. And only later on I learned it helped me to be fast in reaching out for things. The missile crisis had just happened. Kennedy, the confrontation, Khrushchev had to pull them out. And Che and Fidel and the delegation went to the United Nations in New York. There was a woman, she was a star reporter for Look magazine, and she hassled him so much that finally said, okay, signora, if the Pentagon gives you permission, you're welcome, and I'll show you around what we've done in 3 years of the revolution. I came in and I said, hello. He was Minister of Industry, the bank director, Banco Nacional, and the what do you call, the blinds were drawn. And I said, Che, it's a little dark in here, can I open it? He said, no. I said, okay. So I had to change my technical things, ASN. I said, it's your face, not mine. And I started working for 3 hours, dancing around him. He had this fight with his lady, two ideologies clashing. There was no television at the time, so she had to tell the story, and he was defending, and it was between, you know, very charming. He constantly lit her cigarettes and tried to be polite, and he got back in angry and bit off another Cuban cigar, came out, and he was in his combat dress, sort of, you know. And I felt the man is restless. He wants to get out of it. And I think 2 years later, he left and disappeared. During the whole sequence, or the whole time I photographed, he never looked once at me, even sometimes it was two or three feet away from him. Only later on I realized he was a passionate photographer. They called me, and for a German magazine they would like to do a story on São Paulo. And I climbed around everywhere, got on the roof, and finally on one of the highest buildings. In this moment, I looked down, I had a tele lens at one of the cameras, an icon or whatever, and I saw this man on the terrace. And they came walking, and it just went boom, boom, boom. They come from somewhere, they go to the edge, look down, and then finish. So from then on, it became a kind of defining man. You didn't know, are they gangsters, are they bankers, are they whatever. And especially with this kind of plunge in, on the left hand, right down in the abyss of mad cities. The picture was then used on books and even in films and things. It became a sort of a kind of icon without me doing anything else. It just sort of snowballed. Sinto muito amor, mas não pode ser. Guernica was like the big shock, war, because this, the buffaloes and the thing. So I said, this man, I just blew me out of my shoes. I must see this man. I got an assignment to go to Spain. I saw the people on a Sunday running towards, and nobody said, ¿qué pasa? ¿Qué pasa? Well, the caudillo is coming. The caudillo was Franco, the monster. So I had my cameras and said, okay, and I ran over there, started photographing. Two guys jumped on me, punched me, took my camera, ripped the film out. I went back with the hotel with my bleeding nose, and now I have to leave Spain. I didn't know where to go. So I sat down and I sort of leafed through San Sebastian, and I see Picasso is going to the bullfights. But where? Lim. 800 kilometers away, jumped in the car, drove all night, found a little hotel there in the corner, and I heard some music. I opened up, and then music came out, and it was a kind of a absolutely commotion there. And I look, Picasso was sitting on his bed, conducting a kind of bullfighters and organ. And I just woke up and I had my camera, I put it up. It was so noisy. And they made a pantomime and he went like this. And I started photographing. I woke up 6, 7 at night and the light was still there and I still had my cameras on. I said, where am I? I had a dream that I met Picasso. In this moment, a young man comes out and pulls me and said, viens avec moi, come with me. And he pulled me into a dining room. And like here, it was like Michelangelo's Last Supper. And the man said, Papa, I found one, it's the photographer. But while this happened, people tapped on the table and shouted, nous sommes 13 à table, we are 13 at the table. And what happened? Picasso, being superstitious, he said, I don't eat with 30 people in this moment. The Swiss guy comes down the stairs and thinking, did I really meet him? The next day we went to the bullfights. One of my early sins, not that in the way you could perceive it, I was in Japan, nearby Korea, South Korea. There was a military coup. Seoul was a sort of bombed out town. And the army took me, it was the 101 airborne parachute district. They said, well, we're able to show you the country. They took me in a village to this brothel. Oh. And showed me that, you know, we are humans too. Of course, the girls would sometimes go like this. But, you know, it's the way you work yourself into a thing. I grabbed some girls and they took a picture of me. You don't just go in, but with discretion. But I just wanted to show at that time another facet. When I came back 20 years later, I couldn't recognize the city anymore. I met Corbusier long time before in the 50s, and I don't know why, but even so I say I'm not the architectural photographer, but I was for some reason have photographed practically all the famous or interesting people in architecture. You know, an architect wants really to show his building, so get clean everything out which is in the, and always had some, in his case, somebody in front. So a Dominican monk with his clothes and then the modern art. And at the beginning he thought I was making fun of him. And I said, Miss Le Corbusier, what I find fantastic is the contrast between people or a sister with her hat or something. And so he let me come in closer and closer and I photographed him for 10 years. Sadat was already the president because Nasser was gone. He had the Six-Day War on his sleeves. They had later a parade. So I went right behind with the commander-in-chief and Sadat through the columns of the rockets and things. And then Russian bombers came, Shukovs came over. The helicopter thing came. Took the picture and when I showed it, I said, excuse me, there were only 3 helicopters, but no problem, I did it the rest with Photoshop. Of course, everybody, I said, no, just kidding. In the old days, we took the picture that we saw, and today we can really manipulate and do things, so we don't know anymore what is really real. The truth is something else, but this kind of manipulation, and I hope just in the future there will be people here that show us some pictures or show the next generation the way, for the misery or for the good things, how the way the world looked like. Imagine in those days, the magazines, Life, Stern, Sunday, they had 20, 30 photographers. I liked to go to the events, but when I got there and everybody was sort of rioting. I walked away or went up to a balcony, and I find maybe some, like this foreman on the roof, a way of saving something which nobody expected, not even me. But then I was ready just to catch it like a fly in flight.